I'd like to share with you today some of the main struggles people report when trying to understand science on the internet, as well as some of the solutions, some of the workarounds that we found. So we know that what we eat is a major determinant of health. Studies consistently rank diet very high, even higher than things like smoking or physical activity. So what's stopping us from eating healthier as a society? One obstacle I'd like to focus on today is confusion. When we Google nutrition or healthy food, the first thing we find are the diet wars. People fighting over their preferences and views. Ironically, while this is taking place, the majority of the population is doing something very different. In fact, most Westerners are on what Dolly Parton used to call the seafood diet. I see food and I eat it. And if the internet is not that reliable, the mainstream media is not much better. A lot of confusing headlines, just giving people whiplash. So if we can't trust the internet at face value, we can't trust the mainstream media, what if we go directly to health practitioners? They should know, right? So a lot of people rely on books for dietary advice. A book projects a certain image of scholarship, of reliability, of substance, right? The problem is popular books aren't peer-reviewed. There's no scientific oversight. So the reality is popular books are a complete coin toss. And many of the bestsellers that sell a ton and become really popular often have very little scientific foundation. To make matters worse, not only are the sources of information contradictory, but there's also a notion that scientists can't agree. And nutrition science just keeps changing every single day. What's healthy today gives you cancer tomorrow and is healthy again the day after that. So let's just ignore these nerds in ivory towers and just eat whatever we want. But is this true? Does our fundamental understanding of what is healthy food keep changing daily? Let's take a quick look at the USDA dietary guidelines, the official food guidelines for Americans. And let's see how ephemeral they seem. Eat a variety of foods, maintain ideal body weight, eat foods rich in fiber, avoid an excess of added refined sugar, excessive saturated fat, excessive sodium, excessive alcohol. Most people would agree this describes our current understanding of a healthy diet. But what I just listed is the first edition of the USDA guidelines from 1980, over 40 years ago. And in fact, the current edition just came out 3 months ago in the end of 2020, is virtually identical on all of the fundamentals. The only meaningful difference is we used to emphasize fat quantity, and now we talk about fat quality. Favor this type and limit that type. Other than that, all of the pillars are conserved and have remained largely consistent over these 40 plus years. Okay, but maybe the USDA is this really ossified institution that just doesn't keep up with the time. The problem is, when we look at other large reputable health organizations, their dietary recommendations are largely identical to the USDA on the essentials, on the pillars. So maybe it's an American thing. Maybe the US isn't keeping abreast of the science. Let's look at the Canadian guidelines. By the way, this is one of the best image representations of a healthy diet around. An image is worth 1,000 words, right? Tells you everything you need to know right here. They suggest half of your plate be fruits and vegetables, some whole grains, some lean protein, and then moderate the added refined sugar, the saturated fat, the sodium, the alcohol. So again, identical to the USDA on all of the fundamentals. And I recently, out of curiosity, looked at a number of countries, the official dietary guidelines for several countries in Europe, in Asia, Australia, Africa, and they are remarkably similar. Again, on the pillars, on the fundamentals. And even the WHO, the World Health Organization, issues its own set of recommendations, and they largely align with the USDA on the fundamentals as well. So we have this worldwide consensus, with the scientific community largely agreeing, the leading experts in nutrition agreeing on the pillars, which doesn't necessarily mean they're right, just because they're all on the same page. But it does mean that there's remarkable agreement across countries, across languages, and across cultures. even though the cuisines, the details vary from country to country, French food, Italian food, Japanese food, Greek food, right? But the fundamentals of health are conserved. So how can there be such a massive disconnect between the scientific community on one side and public opinion on the other? This remarkable agreement among scientists is just not coming across to the public very effectively. So this is the gap we've been trying to help bridge with our content over the last couple of years. And here's one way we've thought about to conceptualize this and try to bring together, try to bridge these two worlds. These are writer Michael Pollan's words. He tried to summarize dietary advice. Eat food, not too much, mostly plants. What he means by eat food is eat real food, essentially as found in nature, not overly processed, not these industrial concoctions made in laboratories that fill up most of our modern grocery stores. And mostly plants, an abundance of fruits and vegetables, whole grains, legumes, etc. And the beauty of this formula, pithy and simple, is that it's not rigid. There's plenty of wiggle room to fit our personal preferences. So if my personal inclination is toward a low-fat diet or a higher-fat diet, low-carb, intermediate-carb, or higher-carb, gluten-free or some gluten, low-sodium or a bit higher sodium, vegan or some animal products, dairy or no dairy, all of these variants are compatible with a healthy dietary pattern. Now, the internet is very good at artificially polarizing issues. So sometimes it may seem like the variants are all there is. So if we're confused by the fights taking place online or the shocking headlines or a popular book touting a fad diet, it's easy to lose track of the big picture. But the truth is, healthy diets are much more similar to each other than they are different. And all of these different variants and personal preferences all exist in a context. They can all fit under the umbrella of a healthy dietary pattern. So as we go about trying to convey this message to a wide audience, we've received a lot of feedback. We've interacted with thousands of people over the years. And we've distilled down basically three big lessons we've learned. And that's what I would like to share with you to kind of wrap things up. One, teach the why. Nobody wants to follow orders, right? We want to understand how things work so we can decide for ourselves. We want to make our own decisions. So what we try to do in all our content is pull back the curtain a little bit and show the gears, show the machinery, explain why scientists say what they say, instead of just passing down commandments for people to follow blindly. Nobody wants that. On that note, we don't try to change minds. We don't try to persuade people of anything. In fact, we're very careful about it, about imposing our personal views. We even try to actively resist sharing our personal opinion too much. At the end of the day, the right choice for each patient, for each individual, is not necessarily the obvious scientific fact. There's a lot of factors that go into it. So the goal of every video we produce is to share the best information on the topic and to break it down so people can make their own informed decisions. That's the guiding principle behind everything we do. And three, it matters. It does make a difference. It can sometimes feel like our individual contributions are insignificant because these problems are so massive. The health issues in our society, the financial interests. So it may seem like the little we can do at an individual level might be insignificant, but the truth is we can have a significant impact. It's been quantified. People receiving nutrition education change their eating habits. In the study, up to 8 times more people followed dietary recommendations after attending these education sessions. So clarity is part of the solution. And on a personal level, I can tell you we get messages daily from people who watched our content, applied it to their lives, and lowered their cholesterol, lowered their triglycerides, lost weight, dropped medication, etc., etc. Now, anecdotes don't prove scientific points, but what they do show is that people are interested in scientific information and in applying that information to change their lives. And you guys are in a great position to communicate directly with the public and effectively save lives. So I'm really grateful that I had the chance to talk to you today. Thank you very much. Say.